For a reaction, we're now joined by the legal counsel of environmentalists Jonila Castro and Jed Tamano. Attorney Dino De Leon of the Free Legal Assistance Group joins Dateline Philippines. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon to all our viewers.
Okay, Attorney De Leon, cases of perjury and a grave scandal already filed against Jonila Castro and Jed Tamano by the DND. Apparently, this case was filed already over a week ago. What do you have to say about this?
Well, it's disappointing because the NTFLCAC and the Armed Forces of the Philippines said that they are really intent on helping Jed and Jonila. And their version of helping Jed and Jonila is actually filing cases against them instead of pursuing an independent investigation as to what really happened. You know, it's disappointing because instead of pursuing an independent investigation, the Armed Forces of the Philippines, the Defense Department, was very busy in covering up all this mess that happened. And we've never heard a single statement from the Defense Department, from the Armed Forces of the Philippines, that they will pursue an independent investigation. Nothing. As if they've already excluded the possibility that indeed there was abduction that happened right from the very start. This is despite the fact that there were posts in social media on the day of the abduction, that there were two girls that were abducted in Bataan. This was despite the fact that the fact-finding committee categorically found that there was indeed an abduction that happened, and Jed and Jonila did that. And this fact-finding committee was composed of independent socio-civic organizations, environmentalists, members of religious organizations, and human rights groups. This is despite the fact that Jed and Jonila only surfaced 10 days after that particular time of reported incident of their abduction. And then all of a sudden, they are in a military camp saying that they surrendered. That's 10 days after. Mm-hmm. Why is it that the Defense Department is not even entertaining an independent investigation, but rather appears to be covering up the mess that their people have created? So this is quite disappointing, okay, that they instead filed charges instead of actually at least saying that there will be an independent investigation about the matter.
Okay, of course, there will be a preliminary investigation into this, and in relation to that, a subpoena has been released. Have you received them?
The client's family have received them, and we confirmed that. And of course, we're going to attend the preliminary investigation, mm-hmm, and we will respond accordingly. But I just want to say, that it is a little bit ridiculous that perjury charges were filed, despite the fact that the witnesses were coerced to execute the documents. If indeed these people, Jed and Jonila, you know, who were victims of abduction, were inside a military camp and were missing for 10 days, of course they will sign a lot of things just so that, because their lives were threatened, they per their reports and per their testimonies, they were blindfolded, interrogated nonstop. They are coerced individuals. So I don't, first-year law student would know that once a person is coerced, that is not tantamount to perjury. But more importantly, what is the perjured statement here? Yeah, we have to ask that question. Is it the affidavit of recantation? Is the Armed Forces of the Philippines saying that they lied in the affidavit, that they actually surrendered? If they're saying that they lied in their surrender, are they now saying that they did not surrender, actually? Okay. Because they're saying that the perjured statement is the affidavit of surrender. So is the Armed Forces of the Philippines or the Defense Department confirming that indeed they did not surrender?
Okay. Okay, Attorney De Leon, the Defense Secretary Gilberto Teodoro is saying there is enough evidence, in fact, to discredit the claims of Castro and Tamayo. Can you say you also have sufficient evidence to discredit at least the perjury charges, which the government or the DND is insisting?
You know, the defense secretary is a lawyer. He's entitled to his own legal opinion. But again, if he indeed personally reviewed the records, we ask the question, what is the perjured statement? Is it the affidavit of recantation? And are they confirming the fact, affidavit of surrender? And are they confirming the fact that indeed these people did not surrender? It really doesn't make logical sense insofar as the official stand of the armed forces of the Philippines is concerned. But of course, we are prepared to defend the rights of our client, and we will pursue the proper legal remedies as well. But the armed forces of the Philippines should have known better and should have pursued an independent investigation instead of further persecuting victims of abduction who are just fighting for their convictions, which are within their constitutional rights to do so.
All right, let's take up some important salient points of the DND statement, the first of which saying the statement of your clients were scripted. That's what the AFP is standing pat on. Your reaction?
Well, who curated the press briefing? It was the press briefing of the Armed Forces of the Philippines itself, or the NPFLCAC. So if there's anyone who was curating it and who's creating that script, it should have been there. It's just that Jen and Junila went off script and actually told the truth. And between the spontaneous statements of Jen and Junila and the script that were being prescribed to them, I think it's apparent that the statements of Jen and Junila are just more credible, are just more consistent with the facts on the ground. Imagine they're saying that Jen and Junila went all the way from Bataan to Bulacan to surrender 10 days after they went missing, and there 10 days after there were reports on the ground and posts in social media that there were two women or two girls who were abducted by armed men. The statements of the, unfortunately, of the NTF-LCAC in this particular instance are just not supported by the facts on the ground. So as to who is creating a script in the cover-up, if, you know, Defense Secretary Teodoro said that he will not allow the armed forces and the legal the processes of the armed forces to become a theater, well, if that's going to be the case, the best thing to do there is to pursue an independent investigation, make sure to hold into account those people who took advantage of the processes of the Armed Forces of the Philippines and who created this mess to begin with. That is the right way to do, the right thing to do to make sure that it will not, all of these things will not become theatrical for the Armed Forces of the Philippines and the Defense Department.
Okay, Attorney De Leon, do you believe you have a strong case? Because the DND is also saying, in its words, hindi ifa-file ang kaso kung hindi malakas. They also believe that they have a strong case against your client.
Well, ultimately, you know, the reason why we're defending the rights of our clients is because they are the victims, and the facts speak for themselves. Eventually, we will submit to the legal processes once this is now in the office of the prosecutor, and we will respond accordingly. We're just stating the facts that happened, and of course, the merits of the case will be evaluated by the authorities and eventually by the courts.
Okay, this is also something that has to be proven. That statement is saying they believe the processes, the AFP, the processes were above board and that the AFP acted in good faith in the surrender of your clients, whom the government claims intentionally humiliated government forces.
You know, if it is really above board, then why is it that they did not allow Jed and Junila access to the independent lawyer? Why is it that they got a POW lawyer there who has no business being there to begin with, because Jed and Junila were not charged with any crime anyway? You know, it is unfortunate that the public attorney's office is being used as a sanitizer, and and the POW is allowing themselves to do this. This is the same kind of story when there were manufactured evidence in the case of Senator Laya de Lima. It was the POW officers as well who were there to actually notarize the affidavits. No, it shouldn't be the case. And the POW had no business being there because Jed and Junila were not being charged of any crime. The POW was not the counsel of Jed and Junila. So that is their only sanitizer.
Okay.
The fact of the matter is the affidavits were executed inside military premises. that is already highly irregular in itself. If they really want Jed and Junita to be free from any kind of coercion, why is it that these affidavits had to be executed inside the military camps? And why is it that they weren't assisted by their independent counsel? Especially since Junita's family already had counsel during that time. And they know for a fact, and there have been reports, that Junita's parents have been looking for her, And why is it that Junita's parents were not involved? Why is it that their counsel, the family's counsel, were not involved? Those are the dubious circumstances. And so the AFP cannot, you know, generally and in blanket manner claim that everything was above board, because clearly it wasn't.
And speaking of Junita's counsel, the stepfather of one of the surrenderees, Junita, was at the press conference, said the two were not intimidated or even abducted, and even he offered to provide them, like what you said, a private legal counsel. Now, aren't your clients worried this might carry some weight against their testimonies?
That was Jed's stepfather. No? Okay. As to what could be the motivations of Jed's stepfather.
Okay.
He used to be an ex-military official, per our understanding. That's with him. But the fact of the matter is, the facts are clear. They were not provided with independent counsel of their own choice. Only the public attorney's office, who can't even produce any engagement agreement with Jed and Junita, affirming that indeed Jed and Junita were their clients.
All right, Attorney Gino De Leon of LAG, thanks again for coming on to talk to us.
Thank you very much, and good afternoon once again.